he's very proud, very proud.
A soldier from Mahaska County is doing his part to fight the war on terror. He's serving in Afghanistan, but his employer is also helping with the war effort.
Augustine and Sons Incorporated is helping so much from the small Mahaska County town of Rose Hill that they have received a national award. Our Emily Givens was in Rose Hill today and is back now to explain.
The honor is so big, no one in Iowa has ever won it before. Now the family farm near Oskaloosa is even catching the eye of the president.
It is the busiest time of year on the Augustine family farm. Not a good time for someone to be missing.
Four family members and then two employees, which one of them's gone. So, joke, half our workforce is deployed. So,
But you will never catch them complaining.
That's an easy person to support when they have such high motivation and personal integrity.
First Sergeant Matt Strasser is training the Afghan National Army. It's his second tour of duty away from his work, his two boys, and his wife, Jessica.
We miss him, don't we, boys? But we strongly believe in what he does. We're very proud of him.
The Augustines are proud, too. So proud, they refuse to let the Strassers pay rent for living in this house while Sergeant Strasser is gone. They did it when he went to Kosovo. They'll do it until he gets back from Afghanistan next June.
It's very generous, and it gives us a lot of peace of mind that we can just continue to stay where we are when Matt's home, and everything will be the same when he gets back.
If we can give him that peace of mind so he can just focus on the mission, then we think we've helped in some way.
Matt was so moved, he wrote the Department of Defense and nominated the Augustines for the very prestigious Employer Support Freedom Award. Not only did the Augustines win, last week they went to Washington with Jessica and the boys for a trip they will never forget.
We got to spend about an hour with the president.
In the Oval Office, just hours before his address to the nation, they also met Vice President Cheney, Secretary of Defense Bob Gates, and picked up their award at a fancy dinner in front of generals, admirals, and governors.
It's pretty surreal to come from a town that only has two stop signs and be feted like a true rock star celebrity in Washington, D.C.
All for supporting a war without wearing a uniform.
We're very, very proud. It's a very humbling experience.
Anything that we do really pales compared to what he has, the task he's got ahead of him.
The Augustines say that you can help in the war effort too without actually serving in the military. There are two websites they wanted me to tell you about, so we put a link to them on KCCI.com. These sites have all kinds of ways that you can help military families. Kevin and Stacy.
Well, you mentioned that they had an hour with the president. So, I mean, this is really an enviable position to be in. So what do you talk to the president about? Or what does he talk to them about for an hour?
Oh, absolutely. An hour, just hours before he addressed the nation about the war in Iraq, the president actually gave them a preview of what he was going to tell the nation and why he felt that way. He also showed them around the Oval Office.
Give them a little tour.
Yeah.
Huh? Well, cool. All right. Thanks, Emily.